Hey everybody, in this video I want to discuss one of the most overlooked muscles used in human walking, the psoas muscle. The psoas muscle is critical to proper posture and walking technique with low impact on your joints. Many people do not engage the psoas muscle properly when walking, and it can lead to a variety of different and common walking problems that end up causing extra stress on your joints and can ultimately lead to pain. The psoas muscle begins attached to your top four lumbar vertebrae and the bottom thoracic vertebrae and expands outwards from the lumbar spine into the pelvis, attaching to the femur. When we have one leg free, if I activate the psoas muscle on that side, I am flexing the hip with it, pulling my upper leg up towards my spine. If we have our weight on the legs and we activate the psoas muscle, what it's doing is pulling the lumbar spine forward towards our legs. That helps to maintain the lumbar posture and the lumbar lordosis here in the lower back. If you're lying down doing a sit-up, if you activate the psoas on both sides, it helps pull your lumbar spine towards the lower legs. One of the reasons I believe the psoas has been ignored is because it's one of our core muscles. And the core is largely ignored when people are doing EMG studies in favor of imagining that all of our movement is coming from our legs. But really, the core is the central mover or guider of all of our movement. And if we ignore it, we're really not going to be moving correctly. So when we are using our psoas muscle correctly, what's happening is this. As we place our heel onto the ground, we are using our psoas muscle on the rear leg to pull the leg forward by flexing it. So imagine pulling my right knee forward as I shift weight. Once I get to the flat foot position, I'm now going to use my psoas muscle on the front leg to pull the lumbar spine forward. And at the same time, I'm using my lower abs, which are also ignored in research on walking, to tuck the pelvis. The combination of those two actions are going to allow me to pull my spine forward while maintaining a vertical posture. Let's see from the side view. When the heel contacts, I am pulling forward from the rear muscle. And then now, once my foot hits the flat position, I'm going to pull forward from the forward leg psoas. And then I'm going to continue to cycle through that, also using the rotation of my upper and lower waist muscles to coordinate with that action. What happens when people don't use the psoas correctly? A couple of different things. First, duck foot walking. You'll commonly see people walking like this, and it's a very large group of people that do that. Duck foot walking is very harmful to the joints. People often think it may be caused by the way they were born, the structure of their body, the rotation of their tibia, but I believe it is a functional issue. When people walk duck-footed, and you can watch in these images here, they will always be using the psoas on the side of the swing leg to step forward, not using the psoas on the side of the standing leg. If we keep our feet straight forward, we can't use the psoas on the swing leg to step forward. You can practice this, face your feet forward, and see if you can step forward with the psoas. All I can do is temporarily lift the leg up into an unstable position and then place it back to get my balance. It doesn't actually move my spine forward any further. This leads some people to lean forward from the upper waist to try to keep the body going. That's when the feet are facing forward. Other people, in order to use the psoas muscle, turn their feet out. Now they can use the psoas muscle on the side of the swing leg to step forward. And that is a huge problem with walking that's very common. Let me give you a little exercise to help you understand how to pull forward correctly using the psoas muscle, keeping proper posture. Place one foot out straight ahead and the other foot angled out at about 30 degrees. And just practice shifting weight forward and backwards. Shift to your rear leg. When you do that, face the forward leg. And then shift forward to your forward leg and you'll face slightly at an angle. And shift back and forth without pushing. Don't try to push yourself forward. Just shift yourself forward and back. Maintain vertical posture. All right, and then when you get to the forward leg, you can see my knee is lined up over my ankle. This is really the equivalent of the position I would be in after my forefoot hits the ground when I'm walking. Now, the first thing you're going to notice is you can't push yourself forward using your glutes on this side. If I try to push my leg down, it doesn't push me forward, it's really going to push me backwards. The only way to get going forward from here is to pull from this muscle. You'll also notice as I do this, I'm not using any momentum. A lot of times people think that we move forward by using momentum from the previous step, but I'm obviously standing still right now. I'm not going to be using any momentum as I engage my psoas muscle on the left to pull the spine forward, and it's going to rotate my spine in the direction of this leg, now lining me up with the direction that this foot is facing. I'm going to do that again. From this forward shift, you can see I have a little angle here. I'm going to pull forward from the psoas muscle. That's going to line me up, and now I can continue to walk straight. If I do the same thing, shifting forward, and I try to use my psoas muscle on the right, what's going to happen is I'm now walking off at an angle to my forward foot, and my feet are now turned out this way. So try to practice pulling forward using the muscles right here that connect your waist to your leg that help to pull the spine forward in a fluid vertical posture that's going to allow you to move with lower impact and keep your feet aligned in the direction of your movement. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, click the like button. Subscribe to the channel if you're not already a subscriber. I'll see you in the next one.